Today's lecture was basically aimed at orienting the participants with regard to what are moving frontiers in the areas of veterinary and animal sciences. And in this particular presentation, I had covered a large number of different areas where new research and developments have taken place. The basically idea was that due to increase in the incomes of the people, there is a increased demand for animal based products and food, and in that sense it is important that we should think about how to increase the productivity per animal. In this particular context, the new areas that have emerged and where the extensive research is globally done were covered. One of the areas that we talked about was the area of animal genomics and marker assisted selection. And another area which has emerged in the past around two decades as a creditable field of research was transgenic animal technology, where transgenic animals are created with regard to making animals more resistant to diseases. Similarly, another area that was covered under the presentation was on the animal cloning, which enables the researchers to clone animals with high productivity, and in this way increasing demand can be met if we have a good cloning platform where high producing animals can be cloned. Already in this particular field, NDRI has already succeeded cloning buffalo. And in the same way, globally, all the livestock species have been cloned. We also discussed in this lecture what are different areas that are important with regard to animal health, including one health where stakeholders in different fields like medical, veterinary, wildlife, agriculture, environment should work together to deal with any new outbreaks that happen. And we also talked about the emergence of antimicrobial resistance, which has become a global crisis, where a large number of these bacterial pathogens, which were earlier amenable to existing antimicrobial agents, have become resistant to diseases. And then we also talked about application of animal genomics with regard to selection, and also proteomics and other platforms that have become available for larger scale diagnostics, just like virochips, where you can have one microchip that can detect all kinds of viruses which are prevalent in particular geographical region. So these are some of the important areas where this present lecture was focused, and we also had discussion about how the future needs of the animal based foods can be met by improving per animal productivity, by smart management, by educating people, because people's education can also prevent 30% losses to production. So holistically speaking, good breeds of animals through selection breeding, then smart management of the farm, and we talk about how these small stakeholders can be united in the form of village as one particular large farm, and accordingly the strategies can be made to deal with one village animal population as a one big farm, and that approach can help minimizing the losses due to diseases or mismanagement, and also improving the production per animal. So in that sense, it is important that veterinary services should holistically include proper education of the livestock farmers. That is one of the most important areas. It has been seen that existing knowledge itself can improve production and decrease the production losses by good management if the livestock owner is properly educated about how animals should be kept at different times of the year. Say, for example, how to prevent stress from the cold, how to prevent stress from the heat, and many other things with regard to fodder and feed choices that are important to keep the animal in good health and good production system. So in that sense, it is important that students that we teach should have all the dimensions, not only of a particular discipline, and they should have overall understanding of agriculture practices, village ecosystem, animal husbandry practices with regard to culture, and holistic education eventually will make things better with regard to dealing with animal husbandry. So this was the main presentation.